Have you ever noticed that in life there are fights which you know right from the get-go who's going to win? For example, a cat against this chair. Yes, someone is definitely losing the Battle of the Bulge. But not all cats are losing, however. Some cats are definitely winning. That cat against the baby clearly was an unfair match, knowing that the cat had clearly been trained by a professional wrestler. But that doesn't mean that the cat would win a fight against every baby. Like, I wouldn't recommend for it to try to take out this baby. That's intimidating. You cannot pay me enough to take on that baby. I would, however, be willing to take on this baby before I get trapped in a death pit with this crazy animal. Oh man, absolutely no way, no way. Everyone is a brave person until a death rat is leaping at you, trying to murder you in a, what was it, a swimming pool? I don't know. You see, sometimes it is possible to look at two fighters and immediately know which one is going to come out victorious. You can just call it right from the get-go, which takes us right into today's Bible story, during which everybody thought they had the victor all figured out. Today we are going to be once again visiting one of my favorite stories in the entire Bible, and that would be the story of David and Goliath. Now, David and Goliath is one of my favorite stories, which means that you may have heard me talk about it before. But even if you have, let me set the scene so that you can remember what specifically is going on in this story. Our story starts off with two opposing forces at a standstill. God's army, the Israelites, are standing on top of one hill, and a pagan army, the Philistines, are on another hill with a valley in between. They are at war. Yeah, but they have yet to attack each other. And that's because a practice of the day, instead of having both armies charged down the hill into the valley to murder most of the people, instead of doing that, they would choose your best fighter from each of the armies, and then they would meet down in the middle, in the valley. Those two would fight, and then whoever was the victor, the other army would become their slaves. That way, when the battle is over, there's only one guy who's dead, and you get a whole lot more slaves out of that arrangement, so everybody was kind of in favor of it. So the Philistines send down their champion, and his name is, you know it, it's Goliath. Now, Goliath was a big, intimidating guy. He was over 9 feet tall. 9 feet tall. He wore a bronze helmet, bronze protection on his legs, a coat of armor. That coat of armor weighed 125 pounds alone. He carried a sword, a javelin, and a huge spear. And just the thought of having to fight this beast of a man would fill the bravest of men with fear.
The Philistine threat continues to grow. Now they have a new champion. Goliath.
one of you fight me!
Yeah, you gotta realize, this is not Mission Impossible where a 5-foot-tall Tom Cruise is gonna take out all these hulking 6-footers. No, that is not gonna happen. This is a 9-foot-tall, highly trained, skilled warrior who can shatter your shield with one blow or bust your sword in half if you attempt to try to attack him. When this champion would come walking out of the ranks, you would have to be certifiably insane to want to go against him in battle. Anyone with half a brain knows that a normal person is going to lose, and they are going to lose fast. Plain and simple. That's just how this is going to play out. Have you ever been up against an enemy like that? And I don't mean literally. Like, I know that you probably haven't been up against a literal 9-foot-tall armed giant who was attempting to murder you. But I think we all have kind of been up against giants. Not literally, but figuratively. Have you ever been up against an enemy that just seemed too big to win against? Maybe it's a health issue that you're up against. Maybe it's an addiction that you haven't been able to kick. Maybe it's problems within your marriage. Maybe it's a kid who has gone off the rails. Maybe it's financial problems. Maybe it's a sin. Maybe it's a personality flaw that you just can't seem to get rid of. Maybe it's your job. Maybe it's your school. There's so many different possibilities. But the reality of the situation is that we all, in our lives, face our own personal giants. And sometimes we face them for so long without really doing anything about them, we are convinced that there is no way that we could possibly beat it. You see, this is the same thing that happened to the Israelites. They just figured there was no way they could win. However, David then enters the story. Now, David is a young shepherd boy. He's less than 20 years old, probably somewhere between the age of 15 and 20, who had been left at home to care for the sheep while his brothers went off to war. Well, Dad sends him to check on his brothers, and when David shows up, Goliath has been challenging the Israelite army every morning and every night for 40 days straight. And out of these 80 times, not once did anyone muster enough bravery to stand on God's side. And you'd think, okay, by the 80th time, they'd probably be used to this challenge by now. But here's what verse 23 reads. We're in 1 Samuel 17, verse 23. As he, David, was talking with them, Goliath, the Philistine champion from Gath, stepped out of his lines and shouted his usual defiance. And David heard it. When the Israelites saw the man, they all ran from him in great fear.
Will one of you fight me? Israelites, you win, and the Philistines will be your slaves. I win, and you will be our slaves.
The warrior who defeats him will be a rich man.
Not one man in Israel, not one of God's people.
Huh. So after seeing him and hearing him 80 times, they're still terrified of this man, and some of them run away just at the sight of him. You know, whether they are literal giants or figurative giants, giants are terrifying. They're called giants for a reason. But we know the story, and we know that David defeats Goliath. But how? How did he manage to do this when everyone else was shaking in their boots and refused to take any action? Well, let me tell you three things that are different between David and everyone else that was there. Because if we can learn these things, what made David special, then maybe, just maybe, we can take on our own giants. So the first thing that made David different, number one, David doesn't hesitate. David doesn't hesitate. Do you know one of the biggest reasons why our giants are so big? a lot of the times it's because we don't do anything about them when they were smaller. The reasons that our giants seem so unbeatable is we've kind of been standing around and watching them for so long that they grew from something small into something so much bigger. And on the very first day that David meets Goliath, he decides to answer the call to fight. He didn't stand around and wait for someone else to do it. He didn't hope that Goliath would just go away on his own or die of natural causes. He didn't say, "I'll give it a week and then I'll see how I'm feeling." No, David didn't hesitate. He chose to fix the problem on day one.
Not one man in Israel! Not one of God's people!
I'll do it.
David, you're no soldier, you're a shepherd.
Yes, a shepherd. As I protect my sheep, God will protect me.
Where is your faith? Where is your God?
I will kill him.
You'll need this.
I'll be better without it.
Folks, if we could be like David and get into the habit of facing our Goliaths without hesitation, they wouldn't get quite as big as they tend to when we refuse to face them. Okay, Pastor, I get that. I understand that. But my Goliath is big now. It is big. And I'm feeling like it's become too big for me to face. Well, honestly, you're probably right. You are probably right. Your Goliath is too big for you to face. But that's why you have to remember number two. The second thing that made David different from all the rest. Number two, David made it a spiritual battle. You see, the reason that nobody else was willing to face Goliath was because Goliath was physically huge. I mean, this guy was absolutely intimidating. But David didn't look at him simply in the physical. Instead, he turned this into a spiritual battle. What does that mean? Well, listen to verse 26. Verse 26. When David speaks about Goliath in verse 26, he says, "What will be done for the man who kills this Philistine and removes this disgrace from Israel? Who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?" You see, David knew that he wasn't in this alone. He knew that God would be there with him. David, as a warrior, as a boy, as a shepherd, he was really unable to defeat a giant. But David, as a believer, now that one could take on anything. Why? Because it wasn't about David's strength. It was about God's. Listen, whatever your Goliath is that you are facing, you aren't big enough. You aren't strong enough. You aren't smart enough. You aren't tough enough to take it on your own. It's a giant. You're right to think that. But guess what? God is. God is. Whatever giant you are facing, God is bigger. You hear me? God is bigger. And if you can start to look at your battles as being more spiritual than they are physical, then you can take on anything. And when you bring your giant down way below God's size, then you're ready for number three. When you put it into perspective, when you look at whatever it is you're facing and say, "Oh, God can take this easily." And it gets you ready for number three. And David's third difference was David attacked head on. David attacked head on. Verse 45. David said to the Philistine, "You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied." And there David is making it spiritual. This day the Lord, not David, the Lord will deliver you into my hands, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head. This very day I will give the carcass of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. As the Philistine moved closer to attack him, David ran quickly towards the battle line to meet him. I think you know how that worked out for the giant, don't you?
Israel has found a champion! Don't waste my time, little boy. You're too young to die.
I will fight you!
There you have it, David, armed with the knowledge that God was on his side in this battle. Well, that gave him the confidence to attack this head on. So at the end of the day, what do we have? We have a boy who defeats a giant, not because he was stronger or faster or tougher. No, he defeats a giant because he didn't hesitate and let the giant get bigger. He defeats a giant because he made it a spiritual battle and not just a physical one. He defeats a giant because he knew that God was on his side. And with that confidence that God could win all victories, he charged headfirst into it. And what I want you to understand today is that if David can beat his Goliath, then you can beat anything if you don't hesitate. If you make it spiritual, and if you attack the problem head on, your giant will fall, just like Goliath fell on that day. Do not be afraid. Do not be terrified, for the Lord your God will go with you wherever you go. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Hope to see you soon. God bless.